From inside Tropicana Field in Tampa Bay, MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. It's been quite a series so far, and the excitement's only ramping up as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, being down 3-1, calling it a do-or-die game is no exaggeration, but these situations tell us a lot about a team's character, and for some teams, it brings out their absolute best, but for others, it kind of proved to be an overwhelming scenario to face, and so we'll see how they show up here today.
And we'll also get to see what kind of killer instinct they have on the other side. Some teams can get a little too relaxed when they're so comfortably in the driver's seat. First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway. And our pitcher in this game, Luis Patino. How about a report on him, Chris?
Well, the hammer is in effect, and he sets it up so nicely because of the velocity on the fastball. We'll elevate that and then break you off when he's ahead in the count. What I love about him, you get into the later innings of the ball game, and the velocity seems to go up.
So just about set now, and here is Anthony Rizzo. One now. Lifted in the air right center field. Kiermaier glides back, hauls it in, and there's one away. Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. Good contact guy, good defender. Singing game 5 at elimination spot, and the spotlight is focused on this guy.
Everybody looks to the star players in big games like this, and this is what you get paid for. Time to come through.
That misses. 2-1 for Judge. He's really developed into more than just a power hitter. He covers the plate well, shows impressive awareness of the strike zone to boot.
That's critical, very important. If you want to be one of the best to ever play, it can't be all about hitting home runs. You have to have plate discipline as well.
Judge rips that one. Kiermaier racing over to make the catch. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Joey Gallo. Big time power. Ball and a strike. Little chopper rolls foul. No score, just getting started. Top of the first. Swings and misses. Third out. Yanks held in check. And now the Rays will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on The Show. Bottom of the first. Starting on the mound in this one, Nestor Cortes Jr. What do we need to know here?
Well, he comes at hitters with a 5-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on 1 or 2 pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control 4 or even 5 of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Bottom of the first, and now Brandon Lau. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. On its way. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. Brandon Lau goes the other way with it. The Rays strike first. It's 1-0.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
Now batting Wander Franco. Next pitch is popped up. Torres makes the play. One down.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Austin Meadows.
Now it's Austin Meadows.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Next offering misses. Two and one.
Two balls, one strike.
That one missing inside. One down, base is empty. That one ripped. And that should be extra bases. Around second now, going for three. The relay throw. He's in there.
Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. Kicks and deals. In for a strike, and it's 3-2. Meadows stands at third with one gone in the inning. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. The run scores from third, and they take a two-run lead. Not stopping, he's going for three. The throw to third, and he's out, trying for three. But they do get a run. And now the hitter, G-Man Choi. Here's a 1-2. And another ball. Two and two. This one high in the air to left center. Hicks makes the grab, and that is the inning. And that is that. We head to the second here at Tropicana Field. It's the Rays 2 and the Yankees nothing. Back now in Tampa Bay, Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
The next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
And there's a base hit to left. Now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. The pitch. And downstairs. The next pitch misses, and now 3-2. Righty delivers, and a swing and a line drive into right field. No trouble here, puts it away for the out, and there's one down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. Looking at Torres, have to say, he's one of the most impressive young players I've seen in recent years.
Well, no question about it. His future is very bright. The city, the organization, both are excited about him. He has a lot to look forward to.
Tying run at the plate. Stays alive. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
First and second, one out. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Aaron Hicks. Next pitch misses, and it's 3-2. And the righty deals. Ground ball could be two. Lau. Off balance feed. There's one. Throw to first, but he beat it. Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. Stanton on third, Hicks at first, two out of the inning. The other way, base hit and a run in to score. And that's going to get into the corner. One run across, relay throw home. The run scores all the way from first. It's 2-2.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Stepping in for the Yankees, Ben Wortvedt. Runner leads away at second. Into center. Kiermaier on the move. Brings it in for the third out. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. 2-2 game. Bottom of the second. Yandy Diaz now. Next one misses. Now two balls and a strike. To kick the pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2. And a pitch. And it's filled up.
3-2.
The wind of the pitch. And that's ball four.
Well, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make the call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
Here's Manuel Margot. Runner at first with no outs here. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Swing and a miss. Safe at second, and that was not close.
Well, with that kind of elite arm he has behind the plate, man, it's a pretty big deal when you can swipe a bag against this dude. Maybe more than anything, it prevents teams from just testing him, thinking that they can even steal a base. But right here, they successfully move that runner up to scoring position. Good job.
That one to first. Rizzo collects. He takes it on his own. That's one out, the bottom of the second.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
The catcher, Mike Zunino.
Here's Mike Zunino. Runner on at third, one gone. Next pitch is outside. 2-1. Kicks and fires. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul.
These guys like this that have so much power, look forward to seeing them hit the ball a long way. But if you're in the stands, or you're in a broadcast booth, or you're a writer, better keep your eye on the game.
And a base hit knocks in a run.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. We just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Here's the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Pretty amazing going way back. Possibly the best center fielder I've ever seen.
And 1-2. And a pitch. Swing and a ball popped up. Reaching for it and brings it in.
The batter, number 8, second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Brandon Lau, next to hit for the Rays.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
Zunino off of first with two away. And a ball and two strikes.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience, not going outside the strike zone.
And that one hammered. That's back there. That one opts against the fence. The relay to the plate. In there. He scores. It's 4-2.
Picks himself up an RBI. Not a bad pitch by any means. Down and away, right on the corner of the zone. Just a better swing, Boog. Stayed through it and hit it hard the other way.
Here's Wander Franco. And he deals. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. The pitch. That one misses. And it's a full count.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Payoff pitch. Got him. Good job at damage control right there. We play two full. It's the Rays 4 and the Yankees 2. Here at Tropicana Field, Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. 2-2 now. Bounce to the right. Lau over to pick it up. Tosses to first. Leadoff hitter gone in the third. It's Aaron Judge now. The pitch. Hot shot to third. That gets by him.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control, and it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
Joey Gallo will hit next. Went down on strikes his first time through. And he chases that one. Now two away.
Got him out on the front foot. Couldn't keep the hands back long enough and played right into the hands of the pitcher.
Man at first. Now here is Giancarlo Stanton. Singled and scored his first time. Patino checks over to first and he's back. The 2-1. Good eye right there. Stanton, a guy capable of hitting it a long way.
Oh, you can tell how comfortable he is. Look at that front foot on the line as he is close to the plate. But he can be very quick to a pitch that is down and in.
That one fouled off. Out to short. That's a hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. And here is Josh Donaldson. He's 0-for-1.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
The 2-1. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. He's a guy that's changed his stance over time. It's been a little more open, straight up, and now more closed. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. That ends the frame. Yanks strand a pair. They trail it here, 4-2. Set for the bottom of the third. Now it's Austin Meadows. And he dodges that fastball. Two one now. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul.
Well, he's back out here for the third, and after the first couple of innings, pretty rough. I think the skipper's looking for him to give him a little bit of length, see if he can save the bullpen some.
The 2-2. Next offering is outside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a payoff pitch. Right side. Steps on first for the out.
Now back. Left fielder. Randy. Arozarena.
Now up for Tampa Bay. Randy Arozarena. Hawaii. line of the pitch. Out towards right center field. Hicks trots over to his left. Makes a nice grab at a full sprint. That's out number two.
Now batting, first baseman, G-Man Choi.
G-Man Choi next to hit for the Rays.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Next offering is fouled back. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Rays held in check here as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Welcome back. Start of the fourth. And stepping in for the Yankees, Gleyber Torres. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Shoots a line drive single into right center. So a runner aboard to start the inning. So, Singy, let's dive into the numbers courtesy of StatCast. Do you even feel contact being made when you hit a ball that hard?
No, I don't think so, Boog. I mean, that's just the best feeling in the world as a hitter. You square it up perfectly, and it's like you didn't even swing the bat. And there are times the ball feels heavy off your bat. You know it, but this is not one of those cases. He sent this one flying 114 miles per hour, so that's flexing your muscles a little bit.
Nobody out, runner at first.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Next offering is foul back.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
The 1-2, and down on strikes he goes, and that's the first out.
Now batting.
So up next, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Doubled his first time up. The 1-1. Fly ball down the line. Pulls up and it drops for a hit. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Two on, one out. And here's the catcher, Ben Wortvedt. Flied out his first time. Right-hander kicks, deals. Found back our way, and that's out of play. The pitch. Off the mark there. Counts full, 3-2.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Runners at first and second with one gone. And a swing and a miss, and there's two away.
Unafraid to throw it right there. That's trust in your stump. Just one out away from getting out of a huge jam.
Anthony Rizzo now at the plate. The pitch squirts away from Zunino.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Next pitch is outside. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Now The 3-1. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Second and third, two down. Bounced up the middle. Lau collects it. Sends it to first. That's the third out. Bottom of the fourth. Here's the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. And a count 1-2.
Well, he hasn't quite settled in out there. Four runs in three innings. He's going to have some quick 1-2-3 innings to pitch deep into this ballgame.
And here it comes. Gallo makes his way towards it. Racing makes the catch. And there's one away.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
The lefty ready and a 1-1. Line drive. And that's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one out single. So Margot is aboard.
They're back in trouble, Boo, and it's just been like this for him most of the game. They've been all over him since his first pitch, and I think he's got a very short leash right now. Really needs to lock it down here.
Mike Zunino next to hit for the Rays. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. And a pitch. Rudder takes off. Pitch misses in. Throw to second. Great jump, and that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close. Margot, the runner at second with one away. Swing and a miss, and that is strike two. Here comes a pitch. And now it's filled up. And a pitch. In the air to left center. Gallo sizes this one up, makes the grab on the run. Runner tags at second, and he moves up to third. Now two away.
The batter, the center fielder.
Here's Kevin Kiermaier. The 2-2. Off the outside edge with that one, and now it's filled up. Left-hand hitter waits. Now fly ball to right center. Picks, ranging into the alley. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll do it. One left for Tampa, but they still lead this one 4-2. And the Rays, they go to the bullpen. Josh Fleming, and he'll work on holding this lead.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And a 1-1. And that one fouled off.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
Kicks and deals. Got him. One away here in the fifth.
Well, I don't think there's a hitter alive that hasn't at some point succumbed to that pitch right there. It just looks like it's in the zone the entire way, and then the top spin and gravity take over in the blink of an eye, and it's just such a tough pitch to lay off of.
And now it's Joey Gallo. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Pitch in the dirt, and the count's even at two.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Got him looking, and now two gone.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for him tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in a game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him. Make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. That one the other way, and it goes just foul. And now the lefty. And that's down and away. Giancarlo Stanton, certainly a physical presence, and Chris, one of the more imposing guys at the plate in the entire sport.
He's a force, and I think it's scary for pitchers thinking about making a mistake to him, because you know you're not going to get that baseball back. He hits the ball so hard, you don't even have to watch him swing. You can just close your eyes and listen and know exactly who it is that hit the ball.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Runner at first with two away. And now here is Josh Donaldson. And a pitch. Next offering misses down and away. And there's ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Gleyber Torres up to the plate. Next offering misses. And that's ball two.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
That one in for a strike, two and two. Kicks and fires. Stays alive. Two on, two outs. Margot going back, back some more. He gets there to make the play. A nice running grab. And that is the inning. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth, and taking over on the mound, Albert Abreu. It's his job to keep his team in the game. Back here at the ballpark, John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton, and set to get us started. Bottom five, Brandon Lau. And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball. At the belt and fires. Ripped on a line. Can't get there. Base hit.
Well, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Wander Franco getting ready to hit. Here's a 1-1. Dribbled up the third baseline. Goes to second. Safe there. And he'll be safe at first.
Didn't exactly square that one up, but sometimes you don't have to. Kind of got it off the end of the bat, but he gets that knock because he was willing to go with the pitch on the outside part of the plate.
Austin Meadows now 1-for-2.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
And the righty deals. Gonna count 1-2.
Well, with both starters out of the game, this quickly becomes a bullpen game, and this is something we see more and more in the game today, especially in the postseason.
First and second here, no outs. Next offering is fouled back. Double play ball to second. Good feed. That's one. On to first. Double play.
Now batting the left fielder, Ramsey.
And stepping in is the speedy Randy Arozarena. Swings here and blasts one left field. That's back. Randy Arozarena hits one out, and they add to their lead. It's 6-2.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
And stepping in for the Rays, G-Man Choi. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball. Right-handed reliever. And that's downstairs and outside. Comes a 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. Now a 6-2 ball game. Top six, and now the center fielder, Aaron Hicks. The Yankees in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
The 1-1. This has always been the better side for Aaron Hicks. The wind of the pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. Hauls it in on the warning track. So digging in, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. And there's a ball. The line to the pitch. On the ground to third. Throw over to Choi. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. Now
back. My goodness, Chris. He had to generate a ton of power in that jump throw for the out. Let's take another look and dive into the numbers from StatCast.
Man, that's an impressive throw right there. I mean, you've got to have a powerful arm to play third base in the big leagues, and he just showed us why he's at this level. He has a cannon.
And now it's going to be Ben Wortvedt. Next pitch downstairs. Three balls and a strike. Next offering is fouled back. Two outs. A Rosarena gliding to his right. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. 6-7-8 due in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Rays 6 and the Yankees 2. Well, we go bottom six. Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz. Check swing. He went. Now 1-2. Righty to the plate. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
The right fielder, number 13.
So a man aboard. And now the right fielder, Manuel Margot. There goes the runner. Swing and a miss. Bro, and they got him.
Well, I really didn't expect him to try to steal second base because he had a very standard lead at best. If you're going to try to get there safely, you've got to get more on that lead. You've got to get a better jump. That was the difference between being safe and out.
That one hammered left field. Way back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. He flexes his power with that swing, and they add a run. It's 7-2.
I'm not really sure how he kept that fair. When you're out in front on a breaking ball like that, such a good chance that it's going to hook foul. But not this time. He kept the hands moving forward just long enough to sneak it inside that foul pole.
Out of the bullpen for the Yankees, Joely Rodriguez. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is. Base is empty, one away. Mike Zunino next to hit for the Rays. Next pitch is downstairs.
Two balls, one strike, and down.
And here it comes. And a swing and a miss.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
And a 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's a 2-2. And there's a foul ball. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Hicks is there for it. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now batting, center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Two outs, base is empty. Kevin Kiermaier, next to hit for the Rays. The
next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Wandy Peralta up and loosening in the pen. Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a ball popped up. That one gets down for a hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a lawn dart in there, and he found a way.
Rodriguez keeping an eye on him. Lau at the plate. The next offering misses. Two balls and a strike. The pitch. Fly ball pretty well struck right field. That's on its way. That one is gone. Brandon Lau bops one out of here, and they boost their lead. It's 9-2. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boog. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dish. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So two away with nobody on. Wander Franco digs in now. And a pitch. On the ground to third. Throws across the diamond. Franco gone on the play, and that ends the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning, not once, but twice. It's now a 9-2 ball game. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Brooks Raley, and a healthy-sized lead for him to go to work with. And welcome back. We go to the top of the seventh, and now the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. And a 2-1 on the way. And fouled off. The pitch. This one popped up. Franco has this one sized up and puts the squeeze on that. And there's one away.
The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Aaron Judge stepping in now for the Yankees. 1-3. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And there are two outs. Joey Gallo steps to the plate. And a pitch. Activity in the bullpen. Jeffrey Springs, the left-handed reliever, appears to be getting loose. Here comes a pitch. Stays alive. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Third out, and that ends the frame. 1-2-3, go the Yankees. They're down 7. It's 9-2. Randy Peralta will take over here. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do. Back here at Tropicana Field, set for the last half of the seventh. At the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Austin Meadows. Swings and misses. That is strike two. The pitch. On a line, base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock. Now here's the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. The pitch. And he swings over the top there. Meadows gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Pickoff throw. Meadows back in standing. Grounded to third. Could be two. Over to Torres. And they get him easily at first. It's a double play.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the first baseman, G-Man Choi.
So two down now, and here is G-Man Choi. The 1-1.
Count
is 2-1. Popped up to the left into foul ground, and that drops foul. And the pitch. And he grounds one to the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Now a new pitcher for the Rays, Ryan Thompson. And he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is. We're at the top of the eighth, leading off Giancarlo Stanton.
No matter what, you're playing this kind of rival to take your game to another level.
And he deals.
Whoa, that's missed out.
Fought off foul. Two two now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball. It used to be that a lot of guys didn't like to throw it because it threw off their release point and their mechanics. And they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, get ground balls. But because hitters get a swing path that can lift balls at the knees up in the air and over the fence, this pitch has come back into play, and they are doing some special things with it.
To the left side, but it is well foul. The 1-2. Sliced hard, but foul. And a 1-2 again. Action in the pen down there. Jeffrey Springs, a lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. And a swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter, and I'm so glad I'm retired.
Two outs, base is empty. Gleyber Torres up to hit. Next offering clips the zone, count even at two. Righty delivers, stays alive. To two now. To third. Throw over to Choi, and the Yanks go quietly. Down in order, go the Yankees. They're down seven. It's 9-2. Clay Holmes on to pitch here, and we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big. On to the bottom of the eighth, down to third baseman, Yandy Diaz. Next one is off the plate, and it's 2-1.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
Kicks and fires. Swing and a ball hammered left field on its way. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. An absolute blast to left. And they tack on to their lead. It's 10-2.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
Manuel Margot next to hit for the Rays. He's already homered here in this one. One, two to Margot. Slider misses outside. And now 2-2. Towards first, Rizzo picks it up. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out.
Now batting, catcher, Mike Zunino.
Mike Zunino will hit next.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
Strike two.
The count is 1-2.
Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. Yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
And a base hit, so a man aboard now with one away.
All over that one right there. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
Here's Kiermaier now. Next offering upstairs. Zunino, the base runner at first with one out. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Rortvedt makes the grab. Two away now.
The batter, number 8, second baseman, Granted.
And a pitch. Swing, and this is ripped down the right field line. Way back there. Out of here. An absolutely majestic shot. And they add a couple more. It's 12-2.
Wow, he's putting on an absolute show in this one, and there's no better time than the postseason to go off at the plate like this. I mean, a three-homer game, always special, but pulling it off in October during the biggest games of the year, that's incredible.
Chad Green ready to go. He's into the game with the bases empty. Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one fouled off, 2-2. And that's just foul. Two two now. Way inside, and that hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, that's not exactly what they're going for when they say one up, one down.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swings through that one above the zone. Bullpen activity starting up now. Jonathan Loaisiga, the right-handed sinker baller. He looks to be readying himself. Lickie warming up as well. The 1-2. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. Foul ball, he stays alive. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. Just kind of sliced that one into center. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
Now batting, left fielder.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Randy Arozarena. And the righty deals. Oh, and now a wild pitch. The tag, and that's out number 3, inning over. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. Last chance coming up here for the Yankees. A new arm into the game, the righty, Andrew Kittredge. And he's got a nice lead to work with.
Andrew.
Welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Stepping in, Aaron Hicks. At the belt and fires. In there at the knees for a strike. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One out.
Now batting.
Now it's the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa, for the fourth time tonight. Left field. A Rosarena brings it in, and there's two away.
Now batting, the catcher, Ben Wortvedt.
And next for New York, Ben Wortvedt. And Chris, his big strength is defense, but it is interesting. In today's world of baseball, compared to when you played, a good defensive catcher is considered differently.
Whatever you get offensively is a bonus, but he's got to put the fingers down. He's got to present pitches to the umpire. They're going to help his pitcher get more strikes.
Kicks and deals. And a ball evens the count.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
Two down, nobody on. Stays alive. Two, two. And he hits a ground ball right side. And that is going to do it. The Rays are off to the AL Championship Series.
Well, a really solid division series win. They can move on to the next round and I think relax a little bit more. Congratulations, boys. Get ready for the ALCS.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 42 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance. A sellout of 31,042. The Rays thank you and hope you'll join us again real soon at Tropicana Field.